Hello my friends, Rune here again from Oslo, Norway. And in today's video, I want to try out my Humorex HDP50. This is the 11-year-old version. I have not tuned it or anything. I only put in the long barrel that my good friend Florian Sølner from homedefense24.com sent me. So, in this video, I will first just to check the energy level. I will try it out with some slugs I made with the AMOL 6 slug making mold. I put a 9.5mm lead ball inside. And as you can see, it has spiral grooves on the skirt part, so I think it will spin in the air, hopefully. At least it looks cool. These are for measuring the energy, because my X-ray Dichrony that I use only reads between 100 feet per second and 399 feet per second. And the rubber balls I intend to use today also will fly closer to 650 feet per second from this pistol. So I want to try first one shot using the slug, muzzle loading it at a tin can. It's a tin can, not a pop can. It is not the world's most solid tin can, but I cannot squeeze it or anything. There are plenty of people down in the woods now, so I don't want to go down into the woods. And last time I used it, about a month ago, I didn't video film it, but I tested it down in the woods here, thinking it wouldn't be loud, but my oh my, this pistol is loud. So I only took 6 shots and I couldn't hit what I aimed at, and that was about 8 meters distance with these balls. So I don't have the highest expectations. After all, it's a paintball pistol with a smoothbore barrel. So by the way, if you wonder how the stock barrel looks, it looks like so. It's identical to the HDR 50, I think. But it has a strange way of holding the balls in place on this part, the shorter end. It has a rubber gasket. And on the front part, it is pinched into the frame. So the only mishap I have had with this pistol is that the rubber gasket had folded inwards, and that happened when I installed the barrel first time. I hadn't pushed it all the way in, obviously, and then it folded in when I was shooting with it. But I opened it up and put it in completely, straightening everything out, and now it should be fine. At least it was fine last time I used it. So let's put in some CO2. First, some silicone spray. And I am down to my last Humorex CO2, but don't worry, I have at least 4 more boxes of those 12 gram canisters. Tip goes outwards like so, and then you put in like so. It is not gas up yet. You need to hit. this piece where it says push first, and then this pressure indicator pops out in the rear there. So let's muzzle load this slug. The slug weighs roughly 86 grams. And that will be below 400 feet per second. And then we can get some sort of energy level from it. And then we can try out the rubber balls. So, one moment. So, let us see how it goes. Putting the tin can inside the trap there. And we need the extra electronic. Gassing up. Like so. Quick and easy. Because I have shitty arthritic fingers, I will use my middle finger or traffic finger for pulling the trigger. So 86 grain roughly, that's about 5.5 gram if my math is correct. So let's see, a room temperature 20 degrees Celsius. Entry hole, exit hole, and the slug survived. Okay, let me put up the tin can again and we can try first a couple of shots at close range with the rubber balls. Like so. No chrono numbers, because this thing will fly way faster. So, about just over a meter distance, shooting at that tin can. Let's see if it will make a hole. You bet. But the ball stays inside. It cracked the rear of the can. Let me take this up. Here's the ball. A little filthy, otherwise no problem. Let me step back a little bit further. I hit next to the other place and I can't see any dents. Yes, there's a dent there. Here's the ball. Let me put it up again. Twisting it more sideways again. Entry hole, and it cracked the rear there. Oh, sorry, it blew out there. My oh my. 16 grain or 1 gram rubber balls. Here's the ball. it twist it even more sideways. Let me step back even further. I hit it, I saw it jumped, not sure exactly where it was. Well, I dig out the ball later. Let me turn it even more sideways. It fell down, not sure where that ball landed. There it is. One more shot. Shot in here and the dent of the can there. Let me try further down. I have washed the balls, rolled them up again. One of the balls had got a nick to it, but I can still shoot it, I think. So but let's see. Targets is in that box over in the bedroom, and I will be standing in the living room here. Let's see if I can hit it. I see the can moving at least, tin can. Let me go straighten it up. And we're out of ammo. So, as you could see, two magazines with decent power. And then it's done. Not sure if it was a faulty CO2 or something, because from what I can remember, I should be able to get about 3 magazines from one CO2 canister. So maybe the CO2 canister was just partly filled or something. I don't know. So, nicely punctured. So as you could see, the rubber balls, even these are the lightest one, 1.06 gram or 16 grain, they managed to make some decent holes in this tin can. But from testing, and I confirmed that this time, even though the first time I used it down in the woods, it was at about 8 meters and it spread out like this. Not sure why. So shooting at roughly 6 meters now. So, and these are the, this is the first shot, the slug, 86 grains. So, both the mold, the AMO6 mold for making these slugs, these are perfect for the HDR50. Both the mold and the longer barrel set can be bought from homedefense24.com. You can buy the pistol here in Norway from gameon.no. And if you're using the coupon code RUNREBELL, you will get a 13% discount. So, cool pistol. Absolutely. Yes. Not more to say about it really. But that's it for today. Hope you liked the video. See you again another time. And thank you for watching.